Welcome everyone. In today's tutorial, I would like to walk you through the basic steps required for connecting the TC router to the internet. First, we will open a web browser and access the web-based manager of the TC router by entering the default IP address, which is 192.168.0.1. I click login on the left over here. The default username is admin. The default password is also admin. It is highly recommended to change the default password the first time you log in to prevent any unauthorized access in the future. Now, to get the TC router connected to the internet, we'll navigate to the menu over here on the left, choose wireless network, and then SIM. We can set the country to USA 310 and click set. Then we will see down here that by default, the TC router sets the APN to managed internet APN. This means that the TC router will reach out and try to find the APN automatically. In this case, it found that my APN is broadband, which is very common with AT&T SIM cards. If you have a Verizon SIM card, your APN might be VZW internet. Now, there are some special APNs out there that the device may not find automatically. For example, if you have a public static IP address associated to the SIM card, the APN will be different than the default APNs of broadband and VZW internet. If you have a custom APN, you can enter it manually by selecting customer APN in the drop-down menu. Since the device already found my APN, I will just leave it set as managed internet APN and move on to the next step. We'll go over to the menu bar under wireless network again and select packet data setup. We want to enable packet data. This will enable the active internet connection. I will click apply and the TC router should now reach out and it should start trying to establish connection to the internet. We can view this status by clicking status and then radio, and we'll see that my provider is AT&T, my network status is registered home, I have a good signal of negative 69 dBm. It is highly recommended that you have good signal when you try to connect the cellular products to the internet. If your signal level is between negative 85 dBm, negative 100 dBm, try to move closer to a window or move the router outside. It can really help during the initial setup to have good signal. And we can see that packet data is online, so I have an active internet connection. It might take a while the very first time your device tries to connect due to an over-the-air registration and authentication procedure with the cellular provider. You can speed up this procedure by improving the signal strength or adding a second antenna. After this initial connection, the device should connect quickly from then on out. I hope this tutorial helped. Thanks.